We're thrilled to be playing, just excited for the opportunity to continue the season and advance this group to the NCAA tournament. We had a good feeling going into the weekend and the selection show that we thought that we may hear our name called, and we were watching some games around the region to see what sort of happened, but had a good feeling and things obviously worked out for us, but just excited and thrilled to hear your name called.
Right, no, we're very fortunate to be playing basketball in March. We've worked all season for this, started in the fall and preseason. We worked hard to get to the position that we're in today, and we definitely are not taking it for granted. We're excited to get started this weekend in Bridgeport.
Yeah, there's a ton of excitement. You know, when we came in as freshmen, they had made that Elite Eight run, and you kind of have an expectation set that one day you're going to have to carry that torch and try to get your team into the NCAA tournament, and to be able to go out in senior year and get that automatic bid, it means a lot to us. It's what we worked so hard for 4 years, and to see it come to fruition really means a lot to us.
Yeah, as a competitor, it still stings a little bit, of course. You know, the outcome was to win, and unfortunately we came up short, but like you said, I had a couple days to reflect. 3 overtime game, that was an unbelievable experience. We had a great atmosphere here, and probably one of the best games, if not the best game I've ever been a part of and played in, so it was definitely a pretty cool experience.
It was a tough loss. Anytime you lose in overtime, let alone triple overtime, you know, it hurts a lot, and you know, you take the next couple days to kind of reflect on it, but then you move forward and you get ready for the next game coming up. Thankfully, that wasn't our last game of the season. You know, we got that automatic bid because this whole year we've been a good team. It doesn't just fall down to one game. But I mean, you know, looking back at that game, maybe 5 years from now, 10 years from now, it's like, wow, like we were a part of hopefully one of the best games, you know, in the NE10 history. Came up 1 point short, but no, it was an incredible experience. I mean, the energy in the gym and everything around it. It was really kind of a once in a lifetime moment.
Michael Bone's done this with us. Right out of the gates when he was a young kid here, we went to the Elite Eight, we won the region, and Mike was a part of that team. And I think, and Mike's been able to lead this group all year, and you've seen a lot of it. Him taking, actually, especially the last 2 months, taking a lot from back then and bringing it forward to this group. Just some of the toughness factors, the ability to show up each and every day and compete at a high level and challenge himself, but the whole group to just the things of what it takes. And that's who he is as a player. He's a guy that affects the game in so many ways, and especially all the little things that, you know, not every player sometimes wants to get involved with.
It's the perfect closing chapter for us. Me and Twitty came into Stonehill together, and we've grown a lot together, and it's been really fun. And we've struggled together, and we've also seen each other accomplish a lot of incredible things, which has been really awesome to see. Adding Bo into that, he's been a great teammate of ours and one of our closest friends on the team. And I think to be able to go out on our 4 years and really look at it as like this was kind of our footprint on the team, you know, it means a lot to us to be able to have a successful year with us kind of leading the pack, I guess.
Yeah, Will and Brandon, for them to play here and advance the NCAA tournament their senior year is pretty special. They've talked about it for a number of years as part of just recruiting when we recruited those guys, and they were coming in watching this group, watching that Stonehill team that they were planning to come to, you know, go to a regional, go to the NCAA tournament, go to the Elite Eight, and they've wanted to do it for years and have talked about it. It's taken a lot of hard work. It's taken a lot of bumps and bruises and just ups and downs and just the grind and the growth, you know, for them to get here to this point. So they're so excited. It's so well deserved for them, and I'm just thrilled. I'm so excited for those guys, and obviously Michael, who's been here a little bit, but now this is a different, you know, role for him to be a huge part of this.
No, like I kind of just alluded to, this is what we worked all year for, to put ourselves in positions of playing big games like this, playing against a respectable program like Jefferson, and give it the best that we can and just compete at a high level, and then we can live with the results.
We haven't played Jefferson in a long time. Haven't played them since they were Philly U, actually, so years ago. And we're excited, though. I think at this point, no matter who you get in the draw, no matter what team you face and your opponent, everybody's good. Everyone's an elite level team, obviously top 8 in the region. Jefferson's ranked, I think, top 15. Last week they may have been 8 in the country or so, and they're fantastic. They're just a very dynamic team that can score at every spot on the floor. I think things start with their coach, with Herb McGee, who's been here for a long time, and he's he's won more games than days that I've been alive, and he does such a good job with them and has always done such a great job, and he's going to have them so prepared. He's going to have them running just great execution and running great sets and just great actions that are going to be really hard to stop.
I'm excited. I was kind of hoping we'd get to play a new opponent, just so, you know, get a new kind of experience. Jefferson's a very good team. I think they only have like 4 losses this year. They got a really experienced coach and a really experienced group of guys, so it's going to be a great test. Honestly, I don't know a ton about them right now, but you know, as this week goes forward, our coaches do a really good job preparing us for it with the scout and everything, so I'm sure we'll be as ready as possible.